there, it's Candace, and welcome back to the 30,000 Foot View podcast. This is the show for the entrepreneur who is out there hustling to be a part of that 1% club, or the employee looking to climb the corporate ladder. This show will help you to look at the bigger picture so that you can plant seeds today and watch them bloom tomorrow. All right, guys, let's go be great. Hey guys, what's up? It's Candace and welcome back to the 30,000 Foot View podcast. In today's episode, we're going to talk about how you can make room for the good. Every single day, you should be looking for the good in everything that you do and trying to stay as positive as possible. I do not believe in thinking negative thoughts and preparing for the worst every single day. That does you no good. It does nobody any good. Nope, nobody. It's wasted energy, wasted space in your mind, and you need to get that out. So I want to share with you guys just a couple little tidbits of things that I like to focus on every day, why I think the way I think, and how you can try to change your perspective so that you can breed a more abundant life every single day. So if you don't mind, and if you haven't already, go ahead before we jump in and share this podcast episode out with all of your family, friends, share it on your socials, and be sure to go follow me over on Instagram as well as Facebook, 30,000 Foot View Podcast. And I have a giveaway going on right now. You can enter, and all you have to do is whatever platform you're streaming this from, you can leave a rating as well as a review, and that will get you entered. And I will announce the winner on next week's episode. So if you are in your car right now, you're heading into the office and you are ready to get your cup filled up, then let's go ahead and jump into it. All right, guys. So like I said earlier, we are going to chat about what it means to leave room for the good. And this brings me back to a comment that I received on Facebook where someone had left a comment and they said, "I don't understand how you're so positive. I don't understand how you are just happy all the time." And my response is always, "Well, what other choice do I have?" Right? What other choice do you have? Because as far as I'm concerned, sitting around being sad, sitting around being negative, thinking about all the shoulda, woulda, couldas, and all of this, the negative aspects, you know, in life, that's not doing me any good. It's not doing you any good. It's doing nobody any good. So why do it? So I always try to be that, you know, positive Patty that everybody will not be. And I hope I do that on purpose. I do it, number one, for my sanity. I do it because I am not the type of person, I'm not built to withstand a lot of negative energy. Like, I'm just not. Like, I don't deal with it. I don't tolerate it. Nothing infuriates me more. Nothing kills my vibe more. Nothing puts me in a bad mood than someone who is just constantly 24/7 negative about everything. You want a way to piss me off and push me away? That's how you do it. And what I like to really do is I can't breed in that environment. I can't live in that environment. Like, I can't. So, and I don't think it's healthy for anybody. So when I say, cause I say it all the time, and if you follow me on social media, you know, I say it all the time. I have such high goals and dreams and aspirations that those are the things that wake me up every morning. Yes, I have things that I have to do every day that I'm excited about, but my vision is bigger than the day to day. My vision is long term, and it is tunnel vision. It is long term, it is tunnel vision, and it is laser focused, because I know that I was made for so much more, and I am going to figure out what that more is piece by piece every single day. And I don't have time to dwell on the things that went wrong and the negative things that are going on in the world and in this person's life and that person's life and why they're, you know, their feelings are hurt or not hurt and why I didn't do. I don't have time for that because I'm so focused on how I'm going to better position myself and my family. And I think that that's what you all have to worry about as well. For example, if you're in a company similar to mine, Then, you know, it's all about, you know, sales volume. It's all about, well, first and foremost, we know it's about helping people, but the numbers game, the business aspect of it is about sales volume and how you promote up and you advance within the organization is by your sales volume. So you can't compare your sales volume that may be low to someone's who may be high if you did nothing to try to grow that sales volume. You see what I'm saying? So let me break it down a little further. So if you did not show up, and what I mean by show up is if you did not attend meetings, if you did not attend trainings, you don't check in with your team, you don't check in with your customers, you don't take your product, your service, or whatever it is that you're selling, if you don't ask questions, if you are not a product of the product, if you're not a steward of the service, how would you expect your sales volume to grow if you don't show up? Just like if you're in the 9-to-5 world, how would you expect to grow? How would you expect your paycheck to grow? How would you expect to grow by way of title and promotion if you miss every deadline, you call in every other day, you're late for work, you look a hot mess, you're out of dress code, you violate company policies, you're rude, you're not a team player, and you've got all these negative things working against you? How would you expect to grow? To me, there's no difference in those two scenarios. The only thing that is the same is that neither of those scenarios are you doing what you're supposed to do. You're not doing what you were hired to do, and you're not doing what you started out to do. So how could you grow from that? So you have to figure out, are you going to get in or are you going to get out? Are you going to drive that Corvette, or are you going to drive, the clunker out back? Which one are you going to do? The Corvette, or the clunker, the jalopy out there, the one that goes, ooga. Which one are you going to do? Brittany, if you heard that, that was for you, boo. What are you going to do? You have to figure out what is going to fuel your passions every single day so that this stuff is second nature. You don't have to think for 1 second what it is that you have to do. You just do it because it's in you. I don't have, y'all know me, I'm a planner, I'm a list person, I like my pens, my markers, my note cards, all those good things. I like to stay organized, I need my notebooks, I like to stay organized, I like to make lists, but I like to make lists because I like to write. I like to make my lists because I like to use my new pens and my new markers. I know every day what I need to do in order to better position my business. Every single day. I don't have to write that stuff down. It's already in my mind, it's in my soul, it's what I do. I live, I breathe, I sleep it because I know the reason I started doing what I'm doing. I know the reason I started my business. I know the reason I started on my career path because I wanted more for my family. I wanted more for myself. I knew I was made for more. So when you were in that place where you were comparing yourself, when you're comparing yourself to that person that just hit a promotion, that person that just hit a rank, that person that just got a bonus, that person that just got some type of company recognition or whatever it is, you got to think about, did I do the same things that they did to get that recognition and then it's just not my turn? Or did I not do those things and I'm not deserving? Because I'm going to be the first to tell you, if you don't do the bare minimum, you don't do the core responsibilities of your job or what it takes to run your business, you don't deserve the celebratory stuff that comes along with those things. You just don't. And if you think that you deserve it because someone else does it or did it or got it, then we need to have a serious wake-up call. Serious wake-up call. Nothing should be handed to you. You need to work for everything that is good and that it comes your way. You have to work for it. Anything that's just given to you, it's going to be gone the next month. It's going to be gone the next day. It's going to be gone tomorrow. Like, it's just going to be gone. Things that you work for mean so much more. So what I challenge you to do every single night, if until it gets to a point to where it's second nature to you, start mapping out every single night what that vision is. Even if every single night what you write down is the exact same thing, it will be ingrained in your mind. Like, that's one of the things that I love about, because like right now I'm taking a Spanish class. For those of y'all who don't know, I'm taking a Spanish class right now. And, you know, the instructor that we had last week, she was telling us how there is an app, and we can go through the app. The app will make flashcards for us, and this, that, whatever. You know, don't worry about buying index cards and, you know, writing down all these different things. Just get the app. I'm old school. I like flashcards because I like to write, number one, but two, the more I write something down, the more I memorize it. And that's the same thing with your goals, you guys. You have to remember why you set that goal, what you're doing to get that goal every day, and at the end of the day, who it's going to benefit. Where are you going to be when you get there? You have to be so fluent with your goals. It has to be crystal clear, and you've got to be able to just like run and just be so hungry for it. If you're not, then maybe that's not the right goal. Maybe you need to identify something else that's going to make you want to jump up out of the bed every day, that's going to make you want to do those income producing activities every single day that you know that you need to do, but for some reason you want somebody to beg you and tell you every day what you need to do when you already know. That's the difference. I shouldn't have to tell you what to do. You should already know what to do, you know, because these are your goals. You set this goal for yourselves. You joined this company for yourself. You joined this business for yourself. You made that choice. So you've now got to figure out, are you going to do the work or not? And then the other thing is, you can't time yourself and time your success based on somebody else's. If your partner, your teammate, your coworker, your peer, whomever, if they're doing things before you, that's okay. Like, that's okay. It just means it's not your time yet. Your breakthrough is coming, and you've got to keep digging and putting in the work until it comes. You know, your friend wants to go buy a new car. Okay. And so then tomorrow you want to go buy a new car. You have to kind of ask yourself, have I done everything that I need to do in order to be in a position to where me buying this car is not going to negatively impact me? And what I always say is, were you thinking about that car yesterday before your friend said that she wanted to buy a car? No. Okay. Well, then that means you don't need a new car. That just, you're trying to run somebody else's race. Okay, so you have to be prepared for your time when you cross that finish line. You have to be running your own race. This isn't about everybody else. Yes, I understand there are some goals that you probably set for yourself that are super time sensitive. But guys, if you're not prepared, if you haven't mapped out a plan, you don't have a process, you don't know where to start, what you should be doing, time means nothing because you're not going to get there. You can have all the time in the world, but if you haven't planned for it, then I mean, you're wasting your time. You're wasting everybody else's time. So you've got to be dedicated. You've got to be focused, and you've got to be motivated. Don't rely on somebody else to motivate you. You should be self-motivated. You should be self-driven. You've got to figure out what fuels you. People always talk about, oh my gosh, you gotta self-development. You gotta, you know, read a book. You gotta listen to a podcast. You gotta listen to an Audible and this and that, whatever. Huh. Hello. I understand the importance of that. I'm recording a podcast right now. However, if you are not someone who can back up and apply the principles that you learned in that book by listening to that podcast, by listening to that Audible, then you're wasting your time. If you have no intentions of taking what is being said to you to heart, to truly receiving the message, then you're just doing it for show. It's just face value. You're not really doing it to self-develop yourself, right? You're not doing it for the right reasons. So if you're listening to this podcast and you're on your way to work, okay, you get a pass on this one, but I absolutely would expect you to, once you get to your desk, pop those AirPods in and listen to it again and take some notes. If you're sitting at home right now, you're in bed, take some notes on your phone. If you're sitting at your desk, whip out that notebook and take some notes. Be intentional about the self-development that you know that you need and that people are telling you that you need. Don't go at this without a plan. Don't go at this not thinking that you're going to, you know, back this up and do something with it. You have to be ready to go. You have to be ready to be so laser focused on your goals, your dreams, your vision. You got to have a plan. I can't say that enough. You have to have a plan. I know for me, I have a couple girlfriends that I talk to on a daily basis, and we are constantly, and I hate using the word plotting and scheming, the phrase plotting and scheming, because it sounds so bad, but we are plotting and scheming on our goals. We're trying to figure out, girl, does this make sense? Is this doable? Okay, so what would be the best way to attack this? What should we do? How should we do this? Like, we're constantly feeding off of each other. And that also leads me to something else. If you don't have a circle that's hyping you up every day, telling you that you can do it, and wanting to talk through the proper way to go about achieving your goals, and they're not sitting there being your number one fan, being that hype man, that hype woman for you, then you need some new friends. You need a new circle. Because I tell you what, all of the people that I surround myself with on a daily basis, they want to see me win more than they want to see themselves win. And I'll tell you one thing, I am that person. I want to see everyone on my team win before me. Period. If you don't have a leader like that, find you a new one. I don't care if it's in the corporate world or in your own, you know, independent business. If you do not have a leader that wants to see you win before them, find you a new home. Period. All right, y'all, I know I'm all over the place today, but y'all, these are things that I think about every single day because I see it every day. I see people that get so down on themselves and they think they're failing. They think they're failures. They think that they're in the wrong place. They think they're in the wrong seat on the bus. And sometimes they very well may be, but I also understand that they're probably feeling that way because they're not giving it their all. They're not doing everything that they know that they need to do. They keep telling themselves excuses. They keep feeding themselves with all of these what ifs and this and this and this and this, but those things have to stop. They have to stop. Somebody else can't do the work for you. Somebody else can't run your race. You have to run your race your way and for you. But the thing is, you have to start running. You can't run then stop or not start at all. So when you are thinking about how to really make room for the good, I want you to think about, what are the negative factors that are currently in my life that I need to push to the side? Push them to the side, take them out back, get a shovel, bury them down in the ground, cover them up, and leave them and let them be. Lay them to rest. Because those are the things that are going to constantly weigh you down every single day. So whether it's things, it's thoughts, it's people, you got to figure out a way to clear your mind, clear your environment, clear your headspace so that you can be productive, so that you can be positive, so that you can move forward in life. We only get one shot at this, okay? We only get one shot at this thing called life. And we've got to design life on our terms, in our way, but we have to figure out a way to live life abundantly. We have to figure out a way to live life and reach our goals, but also help serve others in some capacity. We have to figure out how to be a motivating light for others. I do this for myself, because I like to share, I like to talk, I like to share life experiences, but I also know that there are people out there that need a little extra boost sometimes. I know that there are people out there that need a word from somebody, and if I can be that person to deliver that word that resonates with their soul and helps to spark a fire in them, an interest in them, a passion in them, then that's what this is for. Sometimes you can't get life out of a textbook. Sometimes you need to hear life straight from someone's mouth. Sometimes you need to see them living their dreams. You need to see them living out their failures and their successes. You need to see them living out what they did wrong and how they plan to move forward. You need to hear all of those things. You need to see people from different walks of life, different areas, different backgrounds, the whole nine. You need those things every single day. Those are the things that I feel like you see that helped to get the negativity out, because you can see that somebody came from nothing to something. They were crawling before they bawled. They were truly in a place where they could have given up, but they didn't. And they used their failures to motivate them to push themselves forward. You have to be in that same mindset. Move the negativity to another compartment that's far, far away and leave a space to be positive, to be focused, to be dedicated, to be self-motivated, to want to be better than you were yesterday. Stop comparing yourself to other people. However, use their stories to paint the picture of the path that you need to take to get to your end result. Use whatever fuel that you can from other people's journeys, but you've got to then take those bits and pieces and make that journey your own. Y'all, I know I have talked y'all's head off. I said I wasn't going to talk long today, y'all. I said I wasn't going to share too much, but here we are almost 20 minutes in and I'm still talking and running my jaw. So I wanted to say that, you guys. I know that was a lot, but that is what was on my heart today. Again, because I know I'm living it. I know there are so many people that are just in a weird space right now. And I want you all to know that it's okay. Figure out your crap, okay? Figure out what you want to do. Figure out where you want to be. Talk it through with somebody. Y'all, hey, use me as a sounding board. Send me an email, okay? Candace@thebigbluedebutante.com. Send me an email. We will do a one-on-one. We will talk. We will put a plan together. We will figure out how to get you to your next goal, to get you to the vision that you've been sitting there dreaming about for so long. We'll figure out a way to get you there. But it does take some effort on your part. I can't do it for you. Your boss can't do it for you. Your mentor can't do it for you. Your sponsor can't do it for you. You've got to do it for you first. First and foremost, you have to show up and want it for you. If you don't, take some time. Come back when you're ready. Make your comeback story your best story. Okay. All right, guys. I think that is it for today. I will be having a special guest back here on the show very, very soon. I've got some amazing topics that I want to cover, and I'm just so excited. As usual, if you all have any questions, you have any topics you want me to touch on, all you have to do is either visit me over on either of the social platforms, over on Instagram or Facebook, 30,000 Foot View Podcast, and drop me a comment or send me a DM, or you can always send an email to Candace@thebigbluedebutante.com. If you would like to catch show notes after this episode airs, you can go visit thebigbluedebutante.com/30,000 Foot View Podcast. And don't forget to share, because sharing is caring and everyone can listen to this podcast and take a little golden nugget back and have an amazing day. All right, guys, I will see you on next week's episode. Happy Friday.